This is a bill that does away with the long-standing provisions that protect the basic rights of Canadians to ensure that when the police want to go after you, when they want to follow you, when they want to snoop on you, that they have to do it with warrants and... judicial oversight.
That's the NDP MP Charlie Angus lashing out at the new legislation tabled today by the government that expands police surveillance powers over the internet. Among the, and we'll get to some of them later, as well as supporters who say the bill is intrusive and unnecessary. The government insists that it will protect children from child pornographers. The bill is called Bill C-30. Is it giving police the tools they need? And we'll hear from some officers soon. Or is it opening the door for the government to snoop on citizens without enough judicial oversight? Joining me now is the Public Safety Minister, Vic Toews. Minister Toews, good to see you.
And you.
Let's get to this title. The title of the bill is the Protecting Children from Internet Predators Act. Why call the bill that when, and I read through this act right here, the bill rather, the word child's not mentioned at all. Why call it the, you know, child predators act and pornography, but barely in this act at all?
Well, in fact, it focuses on an absolutely huge problem that has become well recognized. We saw just recently a very large bust in the province of Ontario that dealt with this particular issue. The present legislation, in fact, does nothing to stop the proliferation of child pornography, and this will be an essential tool in terms of curbing the expansion of child pornography.
But mentioned this bust of child pornography. As I understand it, in cases like child pornography, the police can already get warrants, they get judicial oversight, and the internet service providers, in almost all cases that deal with child pornography, they always turn over the addresses and everything they need. In other words, 95% of the time this works. Why do you need this whole extra bill that expands the power so greatly?
If you're saying that that in fact happens, which I disagree, then why are the individuals upset about the bill if it simply codifies existing practice? What this bill...
Because it goes farther.
Well, hold it.
Because it would go farther.
No. How can you say it goes farther? If there are no rules governing this entire situation, how can you say the bill goes farther? What the bill does is set up a very clear criteria. The identifiers that the police are allowed to obtain, and they're reduced from 11 to 6, and then... those identifiers then become the basis for the evidence to get a warrant. Now, there is no substantive intervention in your computer or watching you surf the net without judicial oversight. Charlie Angus, who made those statements, totally irresponsible. He's an individual who left the technical briefing after a couple of minutes, made the statements before he'd even read the bill.
I
suggested Charlie Angus, he get back, read the bill, and he will see that he's misleading Canadians.
All right, I want to get the bill. I have read the bill and I've got here. I want to ask you this, but the rhetoric's pretty hot. Before we get to some of the details, yesterday in question period, the Liberal public safety critic who's on this show as well, Francis Scarpaleggia, questioned whether Canadians should be concerned about the privacy of the judicial oversight within the Act. Here's how you respond. I'll show our viewers.
We are proposing to bring measures to bring our laws into the 21st century and provide police with the lawful tools that they need. He can either stand with us or with the child pornographers.
That's pretty explosive language, Minister. Do you think anyone who disagrees with this legislation is standing with child pornographers?
You know, I said that in the context of a vote in the House of Commons. But the point is, even your introduction, you indicated that I had used the word support, which was misleading. I think we have to be very clear. You torqued up the rhetoric in order to make a point, and that's unfortunate.
With all due respect, you said you either stand with child pornographers. I just showed the quote. Isn't that Aren't you the one that's torquing the rhetoric out?
Oh, you just, in fact, what you indicated was to try to slide it into another. The issue of supporting child pornographers is an entirely different issue. And I'm glad you played the full quote. At least you played the full quote so that Canadians could see exactly what I said and why I said it.
But Minister, my point here is, in a sensitive issue that has to deal with judicial oversight,